There was no procedure. Was no procedure how to do this. There was no funding, no guidelines. Uh-huh. And now you are telling us we are going to have the police train for immigration. Do we have a space in the jails? Do we have in the budget? Do you know, it goes with the...
It's a conflict in the sense that if you cooperate with the police, you're going to get in trouble. But the U visa would say, we want you to cooperate with the police because if you cooperate with the police, we're going to benefit you in some way. And it just hasn't happened.
Doesn't happen. Could you imagine? Then it's crazy now having this situation with the mayor asking for this. And you know what is the saddest part? That we women, we don't speak up.
How can we speak up? What would you suggest that we do, even non-immigrant populations?
Definitely, because when you think about these immigrant women and the issues they're facing, you think, oh, they are illegal, they deserve that. Yeah, all right. But they don't have affordable childcare. American women, do we have that? We don't. We American women, we don't have national health insurance.
Healthcare, yeah.
You see, fair pay. You know, the same issues these women are facing are our issues, and we need to get together. You know, with this program, when I reach out to families, we talk about all these constraints that makes us to stay there even though we're getting beat up by our husbands.
Yes.
You know?
Makes us more dependent upon the men.
Yes, more vulnerable.
What would you suggest that we do now? Even within this community, let's say, to get some of the changes that we need to be made?
Okay, first of all, I would like to make a call to all women to help me by volunteering, because this is my volunteer work too. And what we are doing is we have an agreement with a nonprofit, and the phone number is there for you to call, and then can volunteer.
The number is up on the screen.
Yes.
Now, and what would you volunteer to do?
Yes, at this point, what I wanted is for them to ask in their own towns a resolution supporting CEDAW. CEDAW is the Convention of the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women that was done by the United Nations.
Only a handful of nations haven't signed this.
Yes.
And we're one of them.
Yes.
Right?
And I want these women to go to their town and ask for this resolution. That will be the first step, because we need to kind of make a statement, okay? And from that, I would like them to go to this volunteer, call me, or call us to volunteer.
Yes.
And from that, we will guide them based in their issues. How we are going to
the issues in their town or in their community.
Exactly. Their issues, because the National Commission of Women, they have a booklet to show us how to become a commission in our own town.
Then we don't even have a commission in Morris County, do we?
No, we don't. We have an advisory board on women.
To the freeholders,
yes.
Which is our governing organization. It's an advisory board, but not a commission on the status of women.
No, we don't have a commission. And but we can have a commission at the local level, like the Commission on Women of Denville, Commission of Women of...
So each town could have their own commission.
Yes, each town can have. And then what I would like to see, if women want to do this, I can provide them with the information. Even at the National Association of the Commission of Women, they have the information. The only thing they need to do is just to read the booklet, and it's done. The work is done. You know, it's not like you say, oh, the resolutions, how we do the bylaws, how we do. No, it's
so
done.
They could then be working on their local issues together,
yes.
Even if we don't have one at the county level?
When we are working at the local level, We will come together to get the county.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what is important is the grassroots.
The grassroots.
And some with respect to our kids. We want our kids, like if you see how many girls are in engineering, how many girls are in science, it's because it's not expected. then suppose that there is this organization and they are saying, you know what, I belong to the Chamber of Commerce and I want girls to get involved in businesses. Then this woman that is in Chamber of Commerce, she will say, okay, my friends, my colleague, they are business women, we can address a program to go to schools and talk to girls, business women, talking to girls about that, or engineers. Then each community will address in the project they want to address.
Yes.
But all together we are going to kind of organize in a structured way. Then with Bridge, if they want to volunteer at the schools, because what Bridge is trying to do now is working with the schools at the after school programs. Then we are training the families and helping the school to fulfill No Child Left Behind. Because you know about No Child Left Behind?
Oh, yes.
Then with Bridge is a manual with guidelines from No Child Left Behind targeting the kids who are failing.
So the guidelines are for parents?
For parents, because one of the requirements for No Child Left Behind is to have a parent involvement policy.
Yes.
And then we help the school to develop the policy. We help the school to have, we are working with standards 4, 5, and 6, and it's with respect to the school culture. And then when we train the teachers, we train the parents, they have this sense of collectivism, all of them working together, besides using the resources in the area, because I'm sorry, I'm just talking.
I'm finding this fascinating. What I hear you as being really good at is bringing people together, and people who are different, people who are the same, local grassroots, and then moving into the county, and then onto a larger level.
Yes, and it's you know, and you see me like a single mom, Latina immigrant, right? And at this point, I have the structure for the Morris County, Warren County, Sussex County,
wow.
Somerset County, Parent Information and Resource Centers. But what I need now are volunteers, parents that they want to help me to do this.
Yes.
Because the resources are in the community, but somehow we don't, immigrants, maybe you know them because you are American, but we don't know about that.
You know what hits home to me? There are children who are homeless who don't have a parent to get involved with their special education needs, their individual education plan. And so people in the community are supposed to be advocates for those children, and they have no training at all, and often no particular concerns at all. So you have children who are being treated by the school system in a way that might be not be in their interest, and there is nobody who goes to bat for them. And so any community organizing that you can do of parents and of people who are not parents but who will get involved in the special needs of children
Definitely.
Could be so valuable.
Because that is when we train parents to be parent mentors. Then once a parent is trained, they will go with some other parent and help them.
Exactly. You know, this time has gone so fast, and I appreciate so much
Thank you for inviting me. You're
informing us, particularly because you are part of this community, and we have a crew here, and we have a whole team that can that this resonates with and that can get involved. So I thank you very much.
Thank you to
Hope you'll come back again.
Oh. Muchas gracias.